Hi, this is Atul Gulati from Leverage Edu. The whole world today is struggling to cope up with ways to deal with the COVID-19 situation. Certainly, it is tough. Times are tough and challenging. Should this, however, affect your dreams? Well, not. If you are preparing to appear for the IELTS exam, then why step back? Let's use this time productively and appear for the IELTS test, since IELTS test centers have opened up and the test is being conducted under very safe conditions. IELTS stands for International English Language Testing System. It is an English language test which is popular and essential if you wish to go to the UK, Australia, New Zealand or Canada. IELTS tests your English skills in four sections: reading, listening, speaking and writing. The speaking section is the most challenging of all the four sections. This video will focus on the speaking section of the IELTS exam. The speaking section scares even the best of the English speakers. At the end of the day, however, all of us have known English since childhood, so we shouldn't let the nerves get the better of us, should we? Students do have to give meaningful and lengthy answers, but if we master the art of answering the questions properly, then there's no looking back. The speaking section is divided into three parts: part 1, 2, and 3. This is for both the academic as well as the general exam, which you know are the two modules for IELTS. And also, this is similar to both the paper-based and the internet exam. If you wish to know more about the difference between the computer-based and the paper-based test, please refer to the video above on details of this. IELTS speaking test, like I said, is three parts: part 1, 2 and 3. Part 1 is for 5 minutes. In this, you will be talking to the examiner about yourself. The topics would include work, home, life, health, interests, etc. The examiner will not interrupt you and you will be speaking answering 4 to 5 questions in a period of 4 to 5 minutes. Part 2 consists of a cue card question. You will get a specific topic on a card, which is called the cue card. You will be given a minute to prepare, and then you are required to speak on that specific question with some follow-up questions for about 1.5 to 2 minutes. In the part 3 section, you will be having a conversation with the examiner. This part also lasts for about 5 minutes. Here, you get an opportunity to discuss more abstract ideas and issues. Part 3 judges you a little more and you're required to answer each question in about 3 to 4 sentences. The examiner will then assess and mark you according to the following assessment criteria. The first is the fluency and coherence. By fluency, we don't really mean that you should be speaking too fast. Fluency means you should be speaking naturally, effortlessly, smoothly, and you should have minimal sounds like well, so on. Because if we are using these words, we are giving the examiner an idea that we are not able to access the language properly. Also, giving short and blunt answers shows that we are not able to talk in detail about a specific topic. Coherence simply means being logical and consistent, extending and expanding your answers, and properly connecting your sentences. The next criteria is the lexical resource, which means vocabulary. By vocabulary, some students tend to use long and complicated words in their speaking sessions. However, it is best not to use unfamiliar words, as these could be used inaccurately and perhaps not pronounced properly also sometimes. We should rather use topic-specific words. By that, I would mean, supposing the examiner asks you to speak about your mobile phone, you should use words like outdated, modern, user interface, screen, apps, etc. Since these are related to your mobile phone, the student will get an opportunity to speak very clearly. In case the examiner asks you, what is your favorite pastime? You should not answer very briefly. Rather, you should say, well, I really enjoy photographing. I photograph nature, the sunset, the birds. This gives me immense happiness. So, although you answered briefly, yet you try to be topic specific and use the right words. One should use words very wisely, for they carry value. Even a small error in an international exam like IELTS can mean a lot. And the third one is the pronunciation. By pronunciation, we don't really mean only pronouncing words correctly. We also mean intonation, sound, etc. You should sound interested in the topic and show that you are passionate about it. If you have a positive attitude about the topic, normal intonation will definitely follow. So emotions also play a lot of role while you are talking. So your body language should be pleasant and you should have a smile when you are conducting yourself in the speaking section of the IELTS exam. Another important criteria where the examiner will judge you is if you are having an eye-to-eye contact with him. So try and maintain an eye-to-eye contact with a smile on your face during the speaking section of the IELTS exam. So three criteria, fluency, vocabulary, pronunciation are important, but equally important is also grammatical accuracy. In this, try to avoid grammatical mistakes as far as possible. The examiner may ask you about the past or the future. So you should speak well with correct past tenses and future grammatical structures. Sounds not as tough as we discussed in the beginning, right? So if we do prepare ourselves well, if we prepare diligently and in the most systematic manner, we would get the score we desire. How do we do this? At Leverage, we would request you to please send us an email at the email given in the screen below. You could send us a speaking recording of yourself. We would be sending you a full speaking session. You can send us a recording after you receive the test. We would evaluate the same and we would then mail you back. The examiner or our coach will mail you back the valuable feedback and let you know what inputs you need to improve on. Thereafter, we can take up individual sessions with you and make sure that you do well in the IELTS speaking section. So all the best. Let's gear up and let's do it now. Thank you.